George Gordon Byron, also known as Lord Byron. He was born in 1788, and was a baron with an insane amount of money aged only 10. Byron had a great interest in poetry. He liked using poetry as a way to say whatever he liked, without being held accountable. He even used poetry as an elaborate revenge mechanism, a method of insulting and mocking other poets, sometimes even claiming that they only got published because they paid someone off. Byron attended the University of Cambridge. When Byron was told that dogs weren't allowed in the rooms, he went and adopted a pet bear. A few years later, Byron published some books and became quite famous in London. He reconnected with his long-lost half-sister, who he couldn't keep his hands off of. This led to his wife divorcing him soon after their marriage, deeming Byron insane. Byron was actually present in Percy Shelley's Switzerland home when Mary Shelley finished writing Frankenstein. In 1816, Byron moved to Italy, where he taught himself Armenian, and rewrote the Bible with what he thought were better stories. And perhaps most weirdly, Byron allowed 5 peacocks, 2 guinea hens and an Egyptian crane to freely roam his home in Ravenna. A sudden illness ended Byron's life at just 36, and weird is definitely the best word to describe his life. Scores of odd characters throughout history have gained infamy for their peculiar eating habits, but none of them holds a candle to Tarare. Having consumed everything from stones to live puppies to human flesh, this 18th-century French soldier undoubtedly holds the distinction of being the strangest and most disturbing eater in human history. What we know for sure about Tarare is limited, but the facts that are on record make his story only more unbelievable. Despite weighing around 100 pounds and constantly showing signs of malnourishment, Tarare would regularly eat and eat and eat in amounts that would actually be inconceivable if countless witnesses didn't affirm such stories repeatedly. He could consume a basket of apples all at once, the whole fruit sitting in his cheeks as if he were a chipmunk, witnesses said. Other stories say that he could consume a meal meant for 15 people at one time. But it wasn't just the quantities that he consumed, it was what he consumed that made him even more unusual. Accounts say that he feasted on untold numbers of live animals ranging from cats to puppies to snakes, of which he was said to be particularly fond. In one fit of extreme hunger near the end of his life, he reportedly drank the blood and ate the flesh of human bodies that had recently been delivered to the morgue. The dogs and cats fled in terror at his aspect, one doctor said, as if they had anticipated the kind of fate he was preparing for them. In the end, Tarare died of tuberculosis in 1798. During his autopsy, doctors found that he wasn't merely a madman who would eat anything just because. Instead, they found that he actually did have an enormous stomach that was nearly the size of his entire abdominal cavity, causing him to eat his way into the annals of history. Most people would do almost anything to keep their lover alive and then keep that person's memory alive after they passed on. Dr. Karl Tanzler took those ideas to a whole new level. A German-born doctor who was working at a hospital in South Florida in 1930, Tanzler fell in love with a young Cuban-American tuberculosis patient there named Maria Elena Milagro de Hoyos. Despite his best efforts, she succumbed to the disease the following year, and that's when things got strange. While she was alive, he had given her gift after gift and professed his love for her, but all reports suggest that she didn't feel the same way about him. And if he couldn't have her while she was alive, he was certainly going to have her, he thought, in death. Following her demise, he snuck into her mausoleum and visited her corpse. But when that was no longer good enough, he stole the body from its resting place and took it back to his home. There, he used a plethora of tricks to keep the young woman's decaying body intact, including plaster of Paris and glass eyes to maintain the integrity of her face, as well as coat hangers and other wires to stabilize her skeletal frame. Tanzler also had the corpse wrapped in a dress, gloves, and jewelry, and placed the body in his own bed, which he shared with the corpse for the next 7 years. He said he never committed necrophilia with the corpse, but we may never know for sure. Finally, in 1940, a local boy saw the doctor dancing with a very lifelike doll, and soon enough, he was found out. He was arrested for grave robbing, but the statute of limitations had expired and Tanzler was able to walk free. The body was returned and the doctor lived out the rest of his days alone before dying in 1952.